Okay, last section. The most successful things we did at CD Baby. It would be wrong of me to just start blathering on in these big kind of, moralistic, vague, preachy things and not give some real specifics. So these are the things that in 10 years of running CD Baby and going to lots of conferences and stuff, I would speak to lots of musicians. And more importantly, I would often overhear musicians telling other musicians why they use CD Baby or why they should use CD Baby. So I'd get to hear what things people like had on the top of their mind as like the main reasons they love CD Baby and would tell their friends to use it. So here they are. Number one, we answered the phone on the second ring. You wouldn't believe how huge this is. There were so many times, I think that was the number one most common reason I heard for why musicians would tell other musicians that they should use CD Baby. They said, they pick up their phone, you can call them. I said, dude, I sent my CDs and I just picked up the phone and called them to ask if they arrived, and they answer on the second ring and they say, CD Baby, there's no voicemail system. Somebody else would say, yeah, I was passing through Portland, Oregon and just realized that, hey, CD Baby's in Portland, so I just called them and said, can I come by? And they picked up the phone and said, sure, come on by. They said, these guys are awesome, you can reach them, you can talk to a real person. So I think this is so important because I believe that you should treat your customers the way that you treat your friends. And when your friends call you, you don't put them through some 7-layer voicemail system, press 7 to reach so-and-so. You pick up the phone and you say hello. So if you want to treat your customers the way that you treat your friends, pick up the phone. You wouldn't believe what a huge competitive advantage this was. For example, I think a few years after I started CD Baby, there was some big .com funded company, I think they were called Riffage. They were doing almost the exact same thing as CD Baby, and AOL had given them $25 million out of investment, and I thought, oh my God, you know, my little hobby's time to shut down now. And then Amazon even did the same thing as CD Baby. They opened their Advantage program and made it so that any musician could send their CDs in directly to Amazon. So I thought, okay, there's no way somebody's gonna use my little service run out of my home, right? But no, this one main competitive advantage that I pick up the phone was so massive that people trusted CD Baby where they didn't trust other companies. Huge. Next one, personalized email headers. Tiny but huge. In the little PHP programming code in the place where any outgoing emails are sent, I noticed that at the moment that you're sending the to email address and the name of the person it's going to, that's the same place where you've set the from, saying it's from CD Baby. So for the first year or two, like all outgoing emails just said it was from CD Baby. But then just kind of as a lark one day, I decided to add just two lines of programming code so that I set the from address to use the first name of the person we were emailing. So if your name is Sarah and we were emailing you, it would say that the email was from CD Baby Loves Sarah. And if your name was Marcus and we were emailing you, then it would say CD Baby Loves Marcus. And people love this. People would often reply going like, you people are, what, how did you, are you seriously going in and like adjusting your Outlook settings every time you're contacting me? What, you people are freaky. And then they would forward the email to their friends just to talk about it. And that's the whole point. It was so remarkable and different and weird and also kind of humanizing and acknowledging them as an individual that it just kind of stood out. So tiny little thing you can do. Next one, changes need pizza. This is one of my favorites. So I told you that it would take about 45 minutes to set up a new album at CD Baby when somebody would mail it in. And every now and then, somebody would mail in an album, we'd do all the 45 minutes of work, and we'd put it live on the website. And then about a week later, somebody would reply back going, no, looking at it, I don't think, do you think maybe you could adjust it? I want the album facing this way now, and I think I want to use different clips in the different order, and I think they would actually, you could actually hear their voice talking like that. And I know the feeling, you know, I put out my own album. And I know that sometimes it's like, it's not until you see something in a public place that you realize, you know, you notice some more mistakes or things you want to change. So I totally understood creatively, but it also would take a lot of work for me to do all this stuff all over again. So early on, I just kind of took a chance and told somebody on the phone that was requesting these things once. I said, sure, I'd be glad to do it, but you gotta send a pizza. And they'd say, huh? They'd say, look, the local pizzeria, here's their phone number. They take credit cards over the phone, and they already know where CD Baby is. In fact, they already know our favorite pizza. So because this is going to take like 45 minutes of extra work, you just order a pizza, and we'll be glad to do any changes you want. And they would think I was kidding, right? I'd say, no, I'm serious. Like, I just want you to acknowledge that it takes a lot of extra work to do this. And there's a real person here who has to do this work. So we'd be glad to do anything you want. Just get a pizza. And people would often, again, it's like at conferences when I'd hear musicians telling other musicians about CD Baby, they'd use this example. They'd say, dude, there's this great company in CD Baby and they're awesome. And you know what? I had to make a change to my album once. They told me I had to order a pizza to make the change. Isn't that awesome? And I think the whole point is, if I kind of like step back and dissect it, it's that it was humanizing it. You know, too often people set up businesses and they almost try to dehumanize everything. They say we instead of I, and they say, dear customer number 43625, and they use boilerplate legalese to kind of cover their ass and do everything to appear to not be human. Like, don't want to admit that it's real people there, right? So this is doing the opposite. It's just reminding customers that it's just real people on the other side. That yes, there's a website, but it's like a real person here doing work and scanning your album artwork and fixing your spelling of your bio and whatever that is. So I think anything you can do in your company that humanizes it, that reminds the customers that it's just real people on the other end, is huge and wins all kinds of love and affection and loyalty, that they now they can relate to you. Next one, customer comments sent to musicians. So at the end of each order, I'd have a place that would ask the customer, where did you hear of this artist? Please just take a second and tell us where you heard of this artist, and we'll forward your comments to the musicians. So people would write things like, oh, I was in Santa Monica and saw you playing on the 3rd Street Promenade, then I went home to Yahoo and searched for you and love your music. Or, I heard your music on KEXP Radio, sounds awesome, went and searched Google and found you, love your music. And so many times over the years, musicians would tell me that some big breakthrough success they had, like whether it was getting their music on a TV show or booking a European tour, all started with one of these little comments, like just introducing the customer to the musician and like getting that two-way dialogue going was huge. And again, it's like this great competitive advantage that CD Baby had over all of the other businesses doing something similar, because they were trying to hold on to their customer data as its proprietary information that nobody must know, this is ours. But in my mind, it's like the customers were just using CD Baby to get at the musician. It's really the musician's customer. I'm just the middleman. Like, let's remember our place here. Next one, special requests with an order. last thing at the end of an order would say, any special requests, just let us know. And I think it said in parentheses, like, yes, anything. And there would just be a big text area box there where you could type anything. And most people didn't, but every now and then people would just experiment. So one guy said, I would love some cinnamon gum. That's all he said. And one of my guys in the warehouse just happened to be making a run to the store when he got to that order that he was packing. So he left it on his packing table, went out to the store anyway, and while he was there, he picked up some cinnamon gum, dropped it in the box with the guy's order, and the guy gets his CDs in the mail, opens it up, and there's some cinnamon gum. And he's like, oh my God, and he goes, you know, he writes a blog article about it, he tells all of his friends about it. Word of mouth, huge. I'll bet like 1,000 people heard of CD Baby because of this one guy that got the cinnamon gum in the mail. But even better, there's a great story out there. I think I linked to it on my site. If you go to sivers.org/squid, S-Q-U-I-D, there's a great YouTube video where I think the story goes that the guy had bought a CD or was buying a CD from CD Baby where the album cover was like somebody with a squid on their head, right? So when he got to the box that said any special requests, he said, yes, I would actually like a plastic or rubber squid. And if you don't have a plastic one, a real squid would do. Thank you very much. And he just wrote this comment to be funny, right? But what he didn't know is that in the warehouse, we had recently received a box of CDs from a guy in Korea. And the guy in Korea had included some shrink-wrapped squid as a gift to CD Baby along with his CDs. Maybe it was instead of pizza, you know. Maybe he needed a change made to his album. And so in the warehouse, the guys had this squid kind of like tacked up on the wall for the longest time in its plastic wrapping still. So when we got this order, they said, all right, we can finally use the squid. And so they included the squid, the real squid, in the order with the CDs. And when the guy got his CDs, he was so blown away that he went onto YouTube and made a video of him telling the whole 5-minute story of his order at CD Baby. And the thing has had thousands of views by now. So thousands of people hearing about CD Baby, all because one of the brilliant guys in the warehouse included a squid in the order. I love that kind of stuff. So the point of all these little stories is that people will remember you more for all the little ways you make them smile than all the other kind of business school, MBA planning, 5-year business plan kind of stuff you do. Like, never forget that all that foundation stuff is important. The numbers are very important, of course. But if you just find these little tiny ways to make people smile, it just means so much more to them than all that other stuff. It'll be like the thing that makes your business and breaks the rest. So I've been living in Singapore for a while now, and I'm often giving this talk here in Asia. And people can kind of look at me and go, ah, yeah, you eccentric Americans, you're kind of weird like that. But no, that's the whole point, is all these things are eccentric in America too, and that's the whole point. It's finding the unusual thing to do, the thing that makes uncommon sense, right? That it's not trying to make your business like everybody else. It's trying to always make your business not like any others and do the things that nobody else will do. Especially if you're a small business, you have all this wonderful advantage that you can just do things because you want to, not because it impresses the board of directors. So these unusual things are so remarkable that everybody tells their friends about you. You can be shockingly unique and use uncommon sense. That's it. I hope this was useful. I hope I can stop talking and do a video camera now. Email me anytime at derek@sivers.org. Some of the coolest people I've met are the ones who've emailed me out of the blue. So please feel free to email and ask any questions or say hi. And I hope this helps. Thanks.